Hello everyone, welcome to the video course on computer graphics. So we are discussing about 3D objects, where up to my last video I have explained about how a 3D objects can be represented. As part of that representation, we discussed about what is a polygon surface, what is a quadric surface, and we also discussed about one curve representation also, that is our Bezier curves. And we also discussed about 3D transformations. The transformations include translation, rotation, scaling, reflection, and shear transformations. So these things we already discussed in our previous video. So let us see about the other concept. We'll be moving to our next concept, that is about 3D viewing. We know what is viewing. Viewing is nothing but we'll be selecting a part of your complete scene that can be called as a shot, and we want to display on our display device. But whenever we are talking about 3D viewing, this 3D viewing is more complex one compared to 2D viewing. Why? Because in 2D viewing, we'll be having objects of 2D and we are having display devices also of 2D. Where in 2D, the world coordinates are converted to window, or the world coordinates are clipped against window, and that window coordinates are translated to viewport for display. This is the thing that is done in the 2D. But whereas coming to the 3D, the complexity is added because of the added dimension. Where in case of 3D, we know we have three dimensions, X, Y, and Z. Where in case of 2D, we have only two dimensions, X and Y. So this is the added complexity. So even though the object is consists of three dimensions, but the display device what we are considering, that is of two dimension only. So that is the complexity involved in 3D viewing. So to compensate or to mismatch this one, the 3D object to a 2D view plane, we have a concept called projections. So projection is a concept where it is used to compensate, or it is used to mismatch the 3D object coordinate representation to 2D viewplane coordinate representation. We'll see in detail about this projection concept in our next video. But in this video, we'll be seeing what is a 3D viewing pipeline and how the coordinate representation, world coordinate systems are converted to a view coordinate system. Those things we'll see in this video. So let us start with 3D viewing pipeline. What is the 3D viewing pipeline? Generally, 3D viewing pipeline, whenever we are considering, the input will be your three-dimensional object, and we'll be getting the output. We'll be selecting one scene, we'll be selecting one shot in that scene, and we want to display that one. So what is that viewing pipeline? So we'll see that one, viewing pipeline. So whenever you want to see, the first step you need to do is you need to select a view volume in the world coordinates, and that is done by using modeling transformation. So by using modeling transformation, so we have a transformation called modeling transformation. By using this modeling transformation, we can convert the model coordinates into world coordinates. Okay, now these world coordinates are converted to 3D object view coordinates by using your viewing transformations. So these will be given as input to your view transformation, where the output of this view transformation will be your viewing coordinates, or you can say view coordinates. Remember, up to this transformation, the coordinates are of three dimension only. But we want to convert this three dimension object to coordinates to two dimensional coordinates. For that, this will be given as input to your projection projection transformation. Okay, the use of this projection transformation is it will convert this view coordinate to 3D, the view coordinates are in 3 dimensional, that will be converted to 2D coordinate representation by using this projection transformation. So you get projection coordinates. And finally, we need to use workstation transformation And the use of this workstation transformation is, it will convert this projection coordinates into the display device coordinates. So we finally we want to display that shot. So that will be done by this workstation transformation. You will get display coordinates, or you can say display device, like that also you can say. Getting all of you? So what is the thing we need to do? First, we need to select the view volume of the complete world coordinates, and that can be done by using model transformation. After that view volume is selected, we will be getting the world coordinates. Now that world coordinates should be converted to view coordinates, and that will be done by using viewing transformation. And after that, this 3D coordinates or three-dimensional coordinates or viewing coordinates should be converted to two-dimensional coordinates, object coordinates, and that will be done by using projection transformation, and we will be getting our projection coordinates. Now the final thing we need to do is that will be displayed onto your display device by using this workstation transformation. That will be done. This is completely your viewing pipeline. Now let us see what are all the viewing parameters required for our three-dimensional viewing. So the next concept is about viewing parameters. Viewing parameters. We know whenever you're considering an object in a three dimension, we can view that object from the top. Like means we can see that if you are considering an object here, you can see like this, or you can see the object from the side also. Side view is also possible, and that object can be seen behind also. Okay, so we have four views: top, left view, right view, and behind. From the front view also we can have. So it is necessary to select a specific view to get a shot of that picture. Getting all of you? Whenever you want to select any slot, any shot of the scene, you need to first identify the view of your, from which view you want to select that, you want to get that shot of the scene. Ready? So what is that view? View generally, so you need to first find out the view. Now we need to select that view by considering one view plane. Get it? So the first parameter is we need to select one view plane. What is this view plane? Is view plane is nothing but a film in the camera from which should be placed at some position, and which should be oriented, or which should be positioned at some location where from which the shot, whenever you are considering one scene, you'll be getting one shot from that. That is about view plane. Getting all of you? And the another point you need to consider as a viewing parameter is you should have a view reference point also. View reference point is nothing but the camera should be focused to that point. That is called as view reference point. Let us consider this is your world coordinates. Let us consider XW, YW, ZW, and these are your view reference. XV, ZV, YV, let us consider. Now these are your view coordinates and these are your world coordinates. Now you need to select one view plane. You know what is view plane? Then it is nothing but a film in the camera. Next we need to select one point also, and this point is called as view reference point. So let us call this view reference point as XF, YF, ZF. What is the use of this view reference point is we need to focus at that view reference point to get a shot from that scene. So we need to select view reference point. And what is the next parameter? The next parameter is we should have a normal vector which should be perpendicular to your view plane. That normal vector should be perpendicular to your view plane. How it will be is, let us consider this is the object you are selecting. So this will be my object. As an example I am considering, and suppose this is your view reference point. I will be representing view reference point with VRP, let us consider. Now this will be my VRP, that is view reference point. Let us consider my camera is here. Okay, now my view plane is this, like this. My view plane, whenever I am talking about a view ref, normal line, which should be perpendicular to this view plane. That means this will be my normal vector, which is n. Let us consider this is n. So we should have another parameter in the viewing plane, that is a vector which is called as normal vector, and it should be perpendicular to your view plane. Okay, now the last parameter we should consider is, it is the distance between the view plane and your object, whatever you are considering. Let us call that distance is r. Okay, the distance that is called, that is as viewing distance. Viewing distance is nothing but the distance between your camera and your view reference point. That is your R. So these parameters you need to consider whenever we are talking about viewing pipeline. What are they? You need to select a particular view. Whether you not view, you want to shot from top, left, right, or behind. Or you need to select, and you need to select a view plane, and you need to select a view reference point. You need to have a normal vector, and you need to set the distance. Okay, these are about different viewing parameters. Now we have set our camera, according to that we will be getting the shot. But now we should know how your world coordinate should be converted to viewing coordinate. That we will be seeing next one. So transformation of world coordinates to viewing coordinates, we will see our next concept. Transformation of world coordinates to view coordinates. Now whenever you want to transform the world coordinates to view coordinates, you need to follow some sequence of transformations. So what are the sequence of transformation are? Before that, let us represent our coordinate system, that is called as view coordinate system. Okay, let us call this is ZW, XW, YW. This is our world coordinate system, and let me represent my view coordinate systems are like this: XV, YV, ZV. Now this is my view reference point. Right? Now as a first step, what we need to do is we need to transform, or we need to translate this view reference point to the origin of your world coordinates. So what is the translation matrix? T of minus XF, minus YF, minus ZF. You need to perform this translation. What is this translation? The view reference point, whatever you are considering for your viewing coordinates, that should be moved to your world coordinates origin point. Now after you will do that transformation, what happens? You will get your object. Let us consider the point, the view coordinates are like this: X, XV, ZV, YV. Right? Now after doing that, what we need to do? We need to perform some rotations, so that if you, for the first time, you need to perform one rotation where this XV will be in line with your XW. Let us call that rotation is RX. Now third step is, you need to perform rotation such that the ZV will be in line with your ZW. So let us call that rotation is RZ. The last sequence of transformation is, you need to perform some rotation so that this YV will be in line with your YW. Okay, so let us call that rotation is RY. Now these are the sequence of transformations you need to perform. So what is the final resultant matrix? You will get, you need to apply translation, which will be this one, and you need to multiply this one with your RX, RY, RZ. So this is the final way, this is the final representation when now you want to perform a transformation to world coordinates. After doing that, you can apply your thing, whatever you want to do. If you want to apply reflection, anything, you can do like using this one. So this is about viewing, 3D viewing pipeline, and where we can, we need to select some viewing parameters, and depending upon that viewing parameters, after that you need to perform a translation of this old coordinates to viewing coordinates. But now we need to see how this, till now we are discussing about three-dimensional objects only. How the three-dimensional objects are connected to two-dimensional object, that will be discussed in our projections concept. That we will see in our next video. Thank you.